Hello everyone, myself B. Raju, Assistant Professor of Chemistry in Freshman Engineering Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering College, Dundigal, Hyderabad. Today our topic is electrochemical cell. So in the electrochemical cell, the topics are galvanic cell, cell notation, and next one is the applications of conductance we are discussing. Electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cell means the cell in which chemical energy converting into electrical energy, that is called as electrochemical cell. In the electrochemical cell, the redox reaction is utilized for generation of electrical energy. What is meant by redox reaction? Redox reaction means spontaneously both oxidation and reduction reactions are occurs. So that type of reactions are called as redox reactions. The electrochemical cells are commonly referred as voltaic cell or galvanic cell. Electrochemical cells. The cell in which chemical energy converting into electrical energy, that is called as electrochemical cell. The best example for electrochemical cell is a galvanic cell. Galvanic cell, comma, voltaic cell. Voltaic cell and Daniell cell. These are the example for electrochemical cell. In the electrochemical cell, the redox reaction is utilized for generation of electrical energy. What is the redox reaction? Redox reaction means oxidation reaction and reduction reactions are at a time occurs. So that type of reactions are called as redox reactions. In the electrochemical cell, are commonly referred as galvanic cell, voltaic cell and Daniell cell. The electromotive force of such cells is directly proportional to intensity of chemical reaction taking place in it. The best example for electrochemical cell is galvanic cell. How to construct the galvanic cell and what we are observing, how the reactions are occurs, and what is the oxidation takes place, what is the reduction takes place, that only we are discussing in the electrochemical cells. This best example for electrochemical cell is galvanic cell. Galvanic cell consists of two beakers. So this is a galvanic cell diagram. So galvanic cell consists of two beakers. In this is the zinc rod, this is the Zn rod, this is the zinc sulfate solution, this is the copper rod, Cu rod, and CuSO4 solution. Now this is the salt bridge. This is the galvanic meter. Now in the galvanic cell, mainly we observed zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution, copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. Both electrodes are connected to the galvanic meter, and both the beakers, the copper sulfate solution and the zinc sulfate solutions, are separated by salt bridge. In the salt bridge, we are using the agar-agar gel solution or KCl solution we are using. In this, mainly we are observed the construction about the galvanic cell is that one. Now observation, what we are observed in the galvanic cell. In the galvanic cell, zinc rod loses electrons, then that loses its weight and Zn form as a Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. So this is called as oxidation. This is called as oxidation. So in the electrochemical cell, anode, this zinc rod is called as anode is the negatively charged electrode. Now copper is the cathode, and this is the positively charged electrode. Now zinc loses electron that form a Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. Now the losing of electrons, what happens, pushes to the copper side. Now copper gains electrons, then copper form as a Cu plus 2 plus 2 electrons form as a copper. So this is called as reduction. What is meant by reduction? Reduction means a tendency of gaining electron is called as reduction, and oxidation means tendency of losing electrons are called as oxidation. The overall reaction is Zn plus Cu plus 2 form as a Zn plus 2 plus Cu. So this reaction is called as redox reaction. This only we are observed in the galvanic cell. Now the galvanic cell, the Daniell cell is a typical example of galvanic cell. In the Daniell cell consists of beaker containing copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution, which is connected to another beaker containing zinc rod. This zinc rod dipped in the zinc sulfate solution by a salt bridge. The salt bridge is an inverted U-tube containing saturated solution of some electrolyte such as KCl, KNO3, ammonium nitrate, which does not undergo any chemical change during the process. The saturated solution is generally taken in a agar-agar gel or gelatin type solution. The salt bridge allows the flow of ions to pass through it when the flow of electric current takes place. It completes the electrical circuit and maintains the electrical neutrality of two half cell solutions. When the circuit is completed, electric current flows through the external circuit as indicated by an ammeter. So this is the galvanic meter diagram. So you see here, this is the zinc rod, the zinc rod dipped in zinc sulfate solution, and copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution. Now zinc acts as an anode, copper acts as a cathode. These both are connected to the voltmeter, and both solutions are separated by salt bridge. So in the salt bridge, this is a U-shaped tube. In the salt bridge, we are taking the KTSO4 or agar-agar gel solution, etc. We are taking. So in this, at the anodic side, zinc rod loses its electrons that form as a Zn, form as Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. In this, zinc rod acts as an anode. In the electrochemical cell, anode is the negatively charged electrode. This zinc rod pushes the electrons towards the copper side. The copper gaining of electron takes place. The copper plus 2 plus 2 electrons form as a copper. The cell, inner cell, is the minus 0.34 volts. The following observations are made in the galvanic cell. Zinc rod gradually loses its weight. The concentration of Zn plus 2 in ZnSO solution increases. Copper gets deposited on the electrode. The concentration of copper plus 2 in copper solution decreases. The flow of electrons is from zinc electrode anode to copper electrode cathode. The flow of electric current is from copper electrode to zinc electrode. Zinc is oxidized to Zn plus 2 ions, which goes in the solution, and therefore zinc rod gradually loses its weight. Oxidation, that is called as, this reaction is called as oxidation oxidation half cell. The electron released at the zinc electrode moved towards copper electrode through external circuit. These electrons are accepted by the copper plus 2 ions in the solution and get reduced to copper, which gets deposited on the copper electrode. So this is called as the reduction half cell reaction. Copper plus 2 plus 2 electrons form as a copper. This is the reduction half cell reaction. The oxidation of Zn occurs at anode, so that is a negative terminal, and reduction of copper plus 2 occurs at cathode, this is the positive terminal. The flow of electrons is from negative terminal anode to positive terminal cathode. The overall reaction is Zn/ZnSO4, so double vertical line. So this double vertical line indicates as a salt bridge. Now copper sulfate slash copper. So this is a cathodic cell. Now the cell reactions are: at anode, Zn form as a Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. At cathode, copper plus 2 plus 2 electrons form as a copper. The overall reaction is Zn plus copper plus 2 form as a Zn plus 2 plus copper. The cell representation is ZnSO4 slash ZnSO4. The flow of electrons is from negative terminal anode to positive terminal cathode. In this galvanic cell, the cell reactions are: at anode, Zn form as a Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. At cathode, is in the form of copper is in the form of copper plus 2. Gaining of 2 electron takes place, then form as a copper. So this is called as reduction half cell. So this is the oxidation half cell. Overall reaction is the oxidation half cell plus the reduction half cell. That is Zn plus copper plus 2 form as a Zn plus 2 plus copper. The cell representation is Zn is the metal solid slash ZnSO4 double vertical line copper sulfate slash copper. So this double vertical line is there, double vertical line is the salt bridge. In this galvanic cell, the important function of salt bridge are: the salt bridge diffusion of ions takes place, in that cations are moving from anode to cathode, anions are moving from cathode to anode. In this situation, accumulated charge prevented and free flow of electron takes place in the salt bridge. That is the important function of salt bridge, in that it provides cations and anions to replace the ions lost or produced in the two half cells. It maintains electrical neutrality of two solutions in the two half cells. It prevents the intermixing of solution as well as ions in two half cells, which may lead to precipitation reactions. It allows the flow of current by completing the electrical circuit. So this is the main important function of salt bridge. So in the galvanic cell, mainly we are discuss about the cell notation. So that cell notation is called as representation of electrochemical cell. So in that first point, so both half cells, that is oxidation half cell and reduction half cell, that means zinc sulfate and copper sulfate, both solutions are there, that both are separated by double vertical line. So the double vertical line is called as salt bridge. Next, second point. To the double vertical line, left side anodic half cell, we are written as anodic half cell. Now, third point. Anodic half cell to the right side where it is cathodic half cell. So this anodic half cell may be written as metal followed by metal ion. This is the anodic half cell. Anodic half cell. Now next, fifth point. How to write the cathodic half cell? Cathodic half cell may be written as metal ion followed by metal. So this is the cathodic half cell. So this cathodic half cell and anodic half cell, we are written in the third point. So anodic half cell is the metal followed by metal ion, double vertical line. Now metal ion followed by metal. So this is the cell representation. This is the cell notation or representation of electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cell. For example, we are taking the galvanic cell. So that in the galvanic cell, Zn and ZnSO4. Copper sulfates. In this, ZnSO4 is the anodic half cell. So simply we are written as Zn/Zn+2. And both are separated by salt bridge. And the cathodic half cell may be written as metal ion, that is copper+2/copper. Like this, we are represented the electrochemical cell. Simply, we are called as cell notation. So, in the electrochemical cell, the difference between the galvanic cell and the electrolytic cell we are discussing now. In that galvanic cell, in this cell, chemical energy converting into electrical energy. And electrolytic cell, the electrical energy converts into chemical energy. In the galvanic cell, anode is the negative electrode and cathode is the positive electrode. But in the electrolytic cell, anode is positive and the cathode is negative electrode. In the galvanic cell, we are using the salt bridge. But in the electrolytic cell, there is no salt bridge we are using. Galvanic cell, this process is reversible and spontaneous. So in this reaction, reversible reaction takes place. That means reactants are converting into products. Products are converting into reactant. That is the process is reversible. In the electrolytic cell, it is the irreversible process and not spontaneous reactions takes place. In the galvanic cell, it is a source of energy. In the electrolytic cell, it requires a source of external energy. The EMF of this cell is positive. In the galvanic cell. And EMF of the cell in electrolytic cell, that is negative. These are the differences between the galvanic cell and the electrolytic cell. Next, coming to applications of conductance. In the applications of conductance, mainly we discussed about the conductometric titrations. In the conductometric titrations, we are used the conductivity meter, acid and bases we are using. So the main function about the conductometric titrations are, without using an indicator, we are determine the end point, sharp end point by graphically. So these conductometric titrations are of five types of conductometric titrations are there. So that conductometric titrations are titration of a strong acid with a strong base, titration of weak acid versus strong base, titration of strong acid versus weak base, titration of a weak acid versus weak base. Last one is the precipitation reactions. In the conductometric titrations, see, this is the conductivity meter. This is the conductivity meter. Conductivity meter. And this is the cell. This is the cell. Now this cell, we are dipping in the beaker. Beaker containing the acid solution. Beaker containing the acid solution. And to this, we are attached the burettes. We are attached the burettes. So that burette containing the alkali. Simply we are called as base. Base. Now this conductivity meter shows the conductance. How the conductivity meter shows the conductance and what happened in the acid-base titrations, let us discuss one by one. First one is the titration of strong acid versus strong base. So in the titration of strong acid versus strong base, strong acid is the HCl and base is the NaOH. When acid is reaction, that means HCl is reaction with NaOH, that form as a salt NaCl plus water takes place. Plus water takes place. When neutralization takes place, we are getting the NaCl plus water. What we are observed in the conductometric titrations of strong acid versus strong base. In the strong acid versus strong base, the NaOH strong base we are filling in the burettes and HCl we are taking in the beaker. In the beaker, we are dip the cell and that cell we are connected to the conductivity meter. Conductivity meter. When NaOH is added to the acid solution, so that H plus ions are slowly replaced by OH minus ions. So that's why what happened? The conductance is slowly fall down. Slowly fall. After reaching the neutralization point, that point, the H plus ions are slowly replaced by OH minus ions. So that's why the conductance is fall down. After neutralization point, there is no presence of H plus ions. So that's why the conductance again increases. Again increases. So the coincident point is, and this is the end point. So by using the N1V1 formula, N1V1 is equal to N2V2, we are calculate the normality of acids. Normality of strong acid. This is about the titration of strong acid, strong base with the conductometric titrations. Next, titration of a weak acid versus strong base. So in the conductometric titrations of weak acid versus strong base, weak acid is the acetic acid, weak acid is the acetic acid, and strong base is the NaOH. When acetic acid is reaction with NaOH, that form as a sodium acetate and H2O. And H2O. So the weak acid is a weakly ionized compound. So that's why what happened? Slowly the curve is, the conductance is slowly increases after the neutralization point, sharp increasing takes place. In this, when weak acid like acetic acid is titrated against a stearin base like sodium hydroxide, a curve shown below is obtained. So this is the curve obtained. The initial conductivity of the solution is low because of the poor dissociation of weak acid. So the weak acid is there now. Weak acid is here, CH3COOH. So this is the weakly dissociated or poor dissociated of weak acid. To the acid, by addition of alkali, highly ionized sodium acetate is formed. The acetate ions at first tend to suppress the ionization of acetic acid due to the common ion effect. Later, the conductivity begins to increase due to the conducting power of highly ionized salt that exceeds that of weak acid. After the end point, addition of NaOH contribute sharp increasing in the conductivity of the solution. So this is the sharp increase of conductivity. First slowly increases, then sharp increasing we are observed. The point of intersection of two curves gives the end point of the titration. End point of the titration. Next, we are discussing about the conductometric titrations of strong acid versus weak base. So here strong acid is the HCl and weak base is the ammonium hydroxide. When HCl is reaction with ammonium hydroxide that form as a ammonium chloride plus water takes place. So in this, HCl is a strong acid and NaOH is the weak base. So when ammonium hydroxide is added to the HCl, so that conductance is fall down first. When neutralization point is over, when that form is ammonium chloride, there is no increasing or decreasing in the conductance. So that means we are getting the completely neutral points. Same points we are getting here. So that is, in this case, conductivity of the solution will first decrease due to the fixing up of the fast moving of H plus ions. After the end point has been reached, the addition of excess drop of ammonium hydroxide is a weak electrolyte. So that's why there is no change in the conductance. There is no change in the conductance. Next, conductometric titrations of weak acid versus weak base. So weak acid is the acetic acid and weak base is the ammonium hydroxide. Acetic acid is reaction with ammonium hydroxide that form as a CH3COONH4. Ammonium acetate and water formation takes place. Here, so acetic acid is the weakly ionic compound. Poor dissociation takes place. So that's why the conductance values are slowly increases. After neutralization point, there is no change in the conductance. This we are observed in the conductometric titrations of weak acid versus weak base. Last one is the precipitation reactions. In the precipitation reactions, mainly we are used KCl solution and silver nitrate. When KCl is reaction with the silver nitrate, that form as a potassium nitrate plus silver chloride formation takes place. So in this precipitation titrations, the end point in the case precipitation titration is sharp. First, when compared with the volumetric titration considered as a precipitation reaction, in the titration of KCl against silver nitrate, the change in the conductivity on addition of silver nitrate is not much, since the mobility of K plus ions and Ag plus ions are same order. So here there is no change in the conductance. So that's why we are getting the same conductance values. After that, end point, there is a sharp increasing in the conductance due to an increasing in the number of free ions in the solution. This is about the precipitation reactions. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.